Now comes the hard part as communities all around the area start to dig out from under the snow.
And for some, it's as easy as shoveling, but for others, blowing snow created snow drifts that has them putting in some extra work. News Channel 8's Marcus McIntosh joins us live with that part of the story tonight. Marcus.
That's right, Kevin and Stacy. Photographer Courtney Kinzer and I did not have to go far to find where blowing snow left behind an awful lot of work to be done. We take you to Prairie City, where neighbors, friends, and family all got involved to help each other dig out from under the snow. We start with Mike Cronin. He sees the same thing each and every time it snows. Wind drifts piling the snow in his front yard 5 feet or higher.
This is our regular snow drift. We get it every year. Out here on the flatlands, the wind just blows like crazy.
Shoveling the snow when it is less than half the height of Cronin's snow drifts is no easy task. Marvin Tuttle, who returned from a Texas vacation last week, first shoveled out his driveway, then went to shovel out a neighbor's driveway the old-fashioned way with a shovel.
But it's pretty thick. It always drifts right in front of the garage door, so I've got extra shoveling to do.
For the most part, a snowblower makes for an easier job than if you have just a shovel. Not when it comes to snow drifts that reach 3, 4, 5 feet and even higher.
That's pretty hard. The snow's hard and it drifts in, it gets harder, so trying to get out here early to move it before it really gets hard.
Admittedly, plowing and shoveling through snow drifts can be an awful lot of work, but we managed to find a family who had a little bit of fun shoveling.
Don't throw that at me. Ah! Oh, now you're asking for trouble.
Jenna Bocamp and her four children, yep. Hannah, Serena, Caden, and Sawyer, are making the best of a very cold and snowy situation.
We were actually doing some schoolwork at home in the house, and we decided that we needed a little break, so we came over to help out some friends who were just on their way back from vacation.
No doubt a nice little break and a nice surprise for the Bocamp's friends who are due back from, get this, sunny Puerto Rico. Now, everyone in this story either had help or was shoveling for a friend, neighbor, or relative, so Prairie City really coming together to help each other dig out from the snow. And Stacy, at the McIntosh household, we're kind of the old school, old fashioned way. I make my three sons do all the shoveling, no matter if their drift's 5 feet high, 1 foot high, or they're sweeping it. My three teenage sons do all the shoveling at my house.
I think that makes you pretty darn smart. Thanks, Marcus.